Racing to the 2022 Kentucky Oaks. Let's get a Tuesday update on your Kentucky Oaks leaderboard. Remember, on Mondays we do our Derby updates. You can take a look at that leaderboard. And right now, let's dive into the fillies for the 2022 run for the Lilies. Big winner over the weekend was Secret Oath. And this horse picked up a nice big victory over 5-length margin at Oaklawn Park. And most likely, trained by Dwayne Lucas, I think he'll be a little bit aggressive. She did run in the Goldenrod Stakes and could be pointing for the Martha Washington or possibly the Fantasy Stakes down the road at Oaklawn Park. A powerful 8-length victory over the weekend. Sire is Arrogate, and kind of an interesting story on this one. The mare is Absent-Minded, and Absent-Minded ran 35 times, was graded stakes placed. She won $600,000. She was trained by Dwayne Lucas. So Dwayne Lucas training the mother, now training the progeny, Secret Oath. Interesting to see what she does if she runs in that Martha Washington. Now, the speed figures Equibase wise, kind of this was a big victory. She got into that lower 90 level, and that puts her competitive with any of the top 10, 12 Oaks fillies on the trail. So she started off with a 72, kind of paired that up with a 71 in the Golden Grod. She had a little bit of trip trouble that day, drew off in the victory at Oaklawn Park with a 93. Now, there was a turf race at Gulfstream Park, the Ginger Brew. A Little Love and Luck came off the pace, 7-1. Made the third move in a turf race, so got perfect time on the move. And the sire, again, Arrogate. So a big weekend for Arrogate, of course. This is his first crop to hit the track, and he's had a lot of foals. So far, they haven't been doing a lot of good running, and this weekend he finally got a stakes winner with Ginger Brew, his first stakes winner, and then Secret Oath. No change on the Oaks leaderboard so far. Echo Zulu, still no official workouts. Juju's Map and Hidden Connection, no workouts officially from them, although Hidden Connection is back on the track. Dreamlith looks like she's going to go be running possibly at the fairgrounds. And Nest, she had her first work back since winning the Demoiselle. That was over the weekend for trainer Todd Pletcher. And of course, Cairo Memories and Tarabi, no works yet in 2022. Now, the prep season continues this weekend at Santa Anita with the Santa Ynez. And then we go to the Silver Bullet Day, the Busanda, and the Martha Washington as we go through the month of January. And of course, the Silver Bullet Day will be run the same day as the LeCompte Stakes, that race for the fillies, as we hit that date on January 22nd. Now, some horses that are considering the Santa Ynez at Santa Anita this weekend. You got Adari Manor, the daughter of Uncle Mo, Big Shamrock, a couple of calbreds, Mr. Big siring Big Shamrock and Big Switch, and then Under the Stars, a Pioneer of the Nile filly, winning impressively in her most recent start. She has been working out and looks like she could be entered on Wednesday in that Santa Ynez. Now the work tab, nothing yet from Hidden Connection. Echo Zulu maybe in the Rachel Alexandra in March. Ida possibly pointing for the Las Virgenes, no workouts yet after winning the Hollywood Starlet. And then we've got Ain't Easy, no workouts. Nest did have a workout. I think they're going to wait their time. I most likely think they're going to stay the same route as Malathot, maybe bring her back with one prep at Gulfstream and then go to the Ashland Stakes at the Bluegrass, or maybe the Fantasy Stakes, depending on the timing of the races that Todd Pletcher likes. And then again, Famed possibly hitting either that Silver Bullet Day or the Rachel Alexandra. I think she's better than that last race indicated as the Kentucky Oaks fillies. It'll be interesting to see if we get some more maiden winners. We've had five or six nice maiden winners on the Derby Trail, only a couple real big maiden winners on the Oaks Trail in the last couple of weeks. Here's the schedule coming up, including races at Santa Anita, Fairgrounds, Aqueduct, and Oaklawn Park, and then the Gulfstream Park kicks it in with the Forward Gale the same day as the Holy Bull in early February. So we're starting to turn the corner. We're into 2022. Any fillies you like on the 2022 Oaks Trail, leave a comment as we get you ready for the 2022 Kentucky Oaks.